Hello everyone. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to analyze the osmosis lab data and then generate a conclusion to test your hypothesis. So what you see here is the data table, a sample data table. Please don't think that this is the real actual 100% accurate data. This is just I made it up to explain the process. So what do you see here in this row, which is the initial mass of the potato cylinders, which you measured first, it's all units in gram. And then what do you see right here in this row is the final mass, which is after 24 hours. So what are we going to do here is we need to find out whether these potato cylinders gained the mass or they lost the mass. So for that, it's very easy. You can do it in the calculator manually. Also, you can do it in Google Sheet. So I'm going to show you quickly how to do this equally in Google Sheet. So now we're going to enter the formula here. So in this column, we're going to calculate total change in mass. So the good thing about the Google Sheet is you just need to do it for one, and then the same formula, if you apply it for all the cells, it automatically calculates for you. So what you need to do is let's find out for zero molar concentration. And so click here in this cell, which is in my case, it is B column and eight row. So B8, and press equal sign, which is a call out sign for entering a formula. So the total change in mass is very simple. You just subtract the initial mass from the final mass. So equal sign, the final mass, which is click on that column on that particular cell, and which is in this case, it's 1.3, and put a hyphen, that is our subtraction sign, and then click the initial mass. So you already see that there's an answer is popping up right here, 0.4. All you need to do is just hit enter. So now you actually, you can see 0.4, you got the answer, which is the difference between the final mass minus initial mass. Now all you need to do is move your cursor to all the way to this corner. You can see my mouse pointer changes to a plus sign, and then click and hold, and then scroll it all the way to the right. Now you can see that answers have been already calculated. And the first two numbers in my case is positive and the rest of them are negative. So the first two, which is positive, that means the potato gained the mass, which is increased the mass. And these four of them, you got the negative number, which means the potato lost the mass. The positive number indicates that endosmosis happened, which means water entered into the potato cell from the surrounding solution. And these four negative, which means the potato cylinders lost the mass. So I'm going to just for easy visualization, I'm going to highlight the negative numbers with in the red tone, and then these two I'm going to give a yellow tone, a background. So now we have to calculate percent change in mass. So for that, what we're going to, all we need to do is we just need to convert this number, and out of 100, how much it changed. So for that, we have a formula. So it's equal sign total change in mass, which is 0.4, click on that cell, and divided by the initial mass. In other case, we are trying to say this much changed. Let me move back here. 0.4 gram a potato gram gained from 0.9. That's how it reached 1.3. So we're going to call out 0.4 gained from out of 0.9. Then all you need to do is shift 8, which is a star sign. That means multiplying out of 100. So it's pretty much, I'm going to change this. You can see it is multiple digits. So the way we change that to two decimal points, so go to format, choose number, and choose this one. So it changes to two digits. So 44.444% increase. You can see that here in this particular potato cylinder when it is in 0.0 molar solution. Again, the same thing how I did before. All you need to do is click and hold this button and move the cursor to the right. There you go. And you got the answers for percent change in mass for 0.2 molar solution, 4 molar solution, 0.6 molar solution, 0.8 molar solution, and 1 molar solution. So that's how you do this calculation here. And I hope this is helpful. And then if you have any questions, please ask me in the classroom or email me. Thank you very much.